If you think about heating and cooling of buildings, it represents about 15% of all greenhouse gas. 15%. And then if you think about food waste, it's amazing that 30% of all food that's produced is actually wasted. Okay, and most of that is because of the way it's transported. So about 10% comes from that. Trane Technologies could have an impact on 25% of all greenhouse gas. Trane Technologies is a global leader in HVAC, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and we put an R on the end of that, which is for transport refrigeration. So HVACR, and we're a global leader. Our purpose is to challenge what's possible and innovate for a sustainable world. You know, we had this crazy thought 4 years ago, which was, look, one company could influence an industry, and that industry could help change the world.
Almost all of our goals related to climate impact have been validated by an outside group called the Science-Based Targets Initiative. We thought it was important from day one that we not just go into some conference room inside the company and come up with numbers. We've done that work, but then we ask outside groups to look at our numbers, look at our data, tell us if we're doing enough. And I think Trane Technologies is one of the companies that stepped back and said, how do we reduce any negative impacts going forward, either of our operations or of the products that we install for customers.
We've been advocating and innovating for climate change and climate action long before it was the norm. And our bold commitments have raised the stakes for the whole industry to challenge what's possible for a more sustainable world. We know that reversing the detrimental effects of climate change requires transformative innovation, and that's exactly what we're doing with our Gigaton Challenge, which is our pledge to reduce our customers' emissions by 1 gigaton, or 1 billion metric tons. And to put that into context, it's equivalent to the annual emissions of France, Italy, and the UK combined. The thermal energy management system is an innovation that Trane Technologies has, where a customer can purchase energy when it's more available and less expensive at night, use that energy to freeze water in big tanks, and then take that frozen water to cool buildings during the day so they don't need to use electricity and energy in the same way that they would.
Our biggest and most long-term goal is our net zero emissions goal by 2050. It's a big one. A lot of companies are talking about it. Our company, though, has been really serious about it from day one, like with our other commitments. Our net zero commitment is the North Star for where we're headed as a company.
When you think of scaling climate innovation and you think of the role Trane Technologies plays in that, it really starts and stops with our people and our customers, because we really innovate from the customer back. But our talent is really what's driving that innovation every day. And that's right from the factory floor to our engineers, to our product management and marketing people. They all play a role. And it's why we are adamant about having the best talent in the industry.
My attitude reflects the product. If I have a better attitude, we get better product. So the idea of troubleshoot, you know, fixing things, knowing that what I did today could affect what happens in 30 days from now, or it could affect tomorrow. That really put a lot of things into perspective for me to understand that being an engineer is far more than just, you know, computers and working with your hands all day.
Our purpose to boldly challenge is really grounded in our 2030 commitments. And one of those is around gender parity, and is also about having a workforce that's reflective of the communities that we work in and that we live in. For us, when you think about creating a culture where women can not only thrive, but they're really core to back to innovation, that's core to helping us innovate. And so we really feel that connection very tightly, and it's a lot of what drives the culture that we're trying to create.
Well, being a quality engineer, my job is to ensure that the product is top tier. We make sure that we do everything in our jobs to make sure the customer is always satisfied. But I mean, it does start with customer satisfaction, but the idea of knowing that we do have a very good quality product, it lets us know and ensure that once these units are on those rooftops or in those buildings, that they're working and functioning properly. So That's the best part of my job.
Our Sustainable Futures program is about how you strengthen your communities. And we want our workforce to mirror our communities. And if you want a strong workforce, you better have a strong community. It's pretty simple. So we work very hard and we have a lot of goals, and we encourage our employees to do a lot of philanthropic events with the community. And it's just so important. And you become ingrained in your community, but you could actually see your community grow. And that's very powerful as well.
So excited to see Trane Technologies invest in talent of the future, starting in middle school and beyond, to create a global talent set for us to take our innovations and ideas and deploy that further. The partnership that we have with schools, with the community, in order to foster this talent is critical for our success and honestly for the industry's success.
We're going to continue to innovate for the future. And, you know, I believe that electrification of heating in our space will be the norm. It won't be the exception, it'll be the norm. I believe that next generation refrigerants will happen. Every refrigerant will have a very de minimis impact on the environment. I believe that air handling in the far out future will have a bigger impact. So at Trane Technologies, we want to have an impact, and we want to have an impact now.